time that I get close to you. You're making me weak with the way you look through those eyes. But all I see is your face. All I need is your touch. Wake me up with your lips. Come at me from up above. Remember the way that you move. You're dancing easily through my dreams. It's hitting me harder and harder with all your smiles. You are crazy gentle in the way you kiss. All I see is your face. All I need is your touch. Wake me up with your lips. Come at me from up above. Oh baby, I need you. See me the way I see you. Love me wide awake in the middle of my dreams. And all I see is your. All I need is your touch. Wake me up with your lips. Come at me from up above. All I see is your face. All I need is your touch. Wake me up with your lips. Come at me from up above.
Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do.
Just really quickly before we get this thing started. After the ceremony, while these two take pictures, everybody is to head over to the Flaming Lily restaurant down the street. I don't know where it is, it's a restaurant. welcome to the marriage of Alberto and Ivan. Save your applause till the end, please. I have to say, I am so thrilled. Oh no. This is my time. I'm so thrilled to have the responsibility to unite these two in marriage. I've had the curious pleasure of watching bloom this thorny flower that is Alberto and Micah's relationship over the past years. Alberto I've known for about 6 years. He used to come into the restaurant, always by himself. and he was just one of those people that makes you make such a profound and lasting impression on you that you think, I'll bet he'd make a good waiter. I should hire him, right? So, yet I had no idea how to get out in touch with him outside of waiting for him to come back and steal more silverware. but as fate would have it, I found myself running into him at Office Max. Right, or passed out on the sidewalk somewhere. I'm like, come work for me, come work for me. And eventually, he did. We became fast friends, which is lucky for him because apparently I'm not that good at hiring people. Ellipses, right? And then one night after work, Alberto goes to Don's place. When I see him next for a long time after that, all he talks about is this girl he met. Codename Penny Dancer. From the song by Elton John. It was Tiny Dancer this, it was Tiny Dancer that. No one knew her name. Actually, I told her not too long ago. In my, she's still listed in my contacts on my phone as Tiny Dancer, right? So in there. But I don't understand it's pronounced. And then somehow she ended up working for me too. I did a little math, and Alberto and Micah are like the third and fourth most frequent people I see in my life. And number two is my dog. So I've seen these two grow from, you know, casual freaky dickies to this, me standing in front of them and about to marry them. How crazy. How crazy is that? It's only appropriate though. I was there when Alberto proposed to Micah and I was like interrupted, ambling by, you know, past them. Little heads up, my God. With a little luck, I'm sure I'll be around for their eventual murder suicide. Either way, this is a thing. A big thing. Thank you. Alberto and Micah, today you are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your life. Your relationship is symbolized. We're in this. Shall we do the same table?
Scott.
Keep down.
Six.
What?
Six.
Oh, they're going to sit down?
Oh, oh, wait, sit. Yeah. Sorry.
Thank you.
All that for me. Like, I command that. I have that kind of presence in there. All right, your relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand, each representing all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Each one holds its own unique beauty, strength, character. They can stand on their own and be whole without the need of anything else. When the two are blended together, yeah, they were about to represent an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. Each grain of sand brings to the mixture a lasting beauty that forever enriches this combination. It will also make a good paperweight. So have fun dragging these things around for us. As each of you hold your sand, separate containers of sand represent your life, individual, unique. As you now combine your sand together, your lives also join together as one. The life that you experienced until now individually will hereafter be inseparably united. The two shall become one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage be. But it's good that they're separate relatives. this is the part where I get to talk about love. Never having performed a wedding ceremony before, you're all like, really, no? But never having done this before, I of course did a lot of research on the topic of love, most of it on the internet, and sometimes once or twice a day. Out of curiosity, I googled the world's oldest known love poem, and guess what? There is one. The love song of Shusin, as it's known, was written more than 4,000 years ago in ancient Mesopotamia. Let's stick with me. The second oldest love poem, if you must know, is about a man from Nantucket. The love song of Shusin celebrates love and beauty and the union of a joyous bride to her king. Coincidentally, the poem was also part of a sacred rite performed every year known as the sacred marriage. In which the king would symbolically marry a goddess, mate with her, and ensure fertility and prosperity for the coming year. Honestly, it's an NC-17 poem with a lot of references to sweet sticky honey and urgings to get to the bedchamber. It's basically, if you will, it's the miso horny of ancient Mesopotamia. Bohemian love poem. It's like archaeologists found the lyrics to My Neck, My Back, chiseled in cuneiform on clay tablets, probably under the mattress of some 14-year-old boy. Some parental guidance, please, Mesopotamian mother. Explicit lyrics go up here. And that was 4,000 years ago. Think about that. 4,000 years ago. A lot has been written about Trump since then. Right? In fact, it could be argued that almost everything written since then has been written about love in some way or another. 4,000 years of poetry by the likes of Shakespeare and Shelley. 4,000 years of love songs, all of them by John Legend, or so it feels like. 4,000 years of plays about like Romeo and Juliet and Romeo and Juliet. I don't really know one of my plays. 4,000 years of Meg Ryan movies. 4,000 years of the greatest romances in history, like Mark Antony and Cleopatra, Han and Leia, right, after the brother thing. Sid and Nancy. But anyway, 4,000 years, which poses the question, why? No one in 4,000 years could say I love you less, right? I think I know why, and I should warn you, a fair warning, I'm the worst kind of know-it-all, the one that's occasionally right, so bear with me. When you fall in love, everything else is inadequate describing what you're feeling in your heart. So we try to express that for ourselves. When you fall in love, it's a temporary madness, like collecting bean bags. It explodes, it's like a volcano, scorches the earth, and then eventually and inevitably, it subsides. And when it subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots have become so entwined together that it is inconceivable to describe polygamy, marriage. Anyway, when that explosion subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots have become so entwined that it's inconceivable that you should ever part. Because that is what love is. Love is not breathlessness, it is not excitement, it is not the desire to mate every second of the day, it is not lying awake at night, imagining that he or she is in there, every part of your body. For that is just being in love. Which any of us can convince ourselves we are in love. Any fool can be in love. Love itself is what is left over. But being in love is part of the way. Right? Doesn't sound very exciting. But it is. You can ask the little guy here in the back. I think some of you know out there too. The handsome one.
Okay.
Probably a couple of you paid no love. But I can say that Alberta. Is she here? Alberto and Micah, they know. 4,000 years of everyone trying to express love in one way or other. But the most important expression of that love is actually has happened right now. Micah, you have something?
Reminder, yeah.
I'll open it for you. It's really Comic
Sans. Yeah, that's good. Is that better? How do you think that today I can officially have it in this moment. There are countless ways to support love and care for me. You always believe in me, encourage and support me to my goals. You're the most beautiful smile and the happiest and the brightest and the most. You're a charming, sexy man and that's just an attitude. I can't promise that everything in life will be perfect, but I know we are perfect together. You will always have my eternal love. I'll be faithful and treat you with respect forever. I promise to believe in you, support your ideas, and encourage you to love your dreams. positive in every situation. Or you say things, I'm just hungry. I'm prepared to cut off hands when the dark side of the force tries to take over our galaxy. Today, for the rest of our lives, I will cherish every moment we share together. I love you.
It's pretty crayon.
Every day you make me feel happy and without me for once, it's become the luckiest night of life. I'm always smiling because of you. You love me the way that words cannot explain. All I do is smile from here to here. I'll spend the rest of my days returning my favor. I'm looking forward to growing old, but not necessarily up, for the rest of my days. I promise to pick you up from your town, positive, when everything else seems negative around us. Make sure you have that silver lining in your sight. Make the good times great times, for my family, and my home, for my kids.
We have the,
swim for him.
Wait, before I get started, I wasn't gonna go off script here, but I was just thinking, like, this reminds me of something.
Thank you.